Hello everyone, Desmond here. So for the past 2 days, I've been watching NES game playthroughs just to reminisce about my childhood. And I thought to myself, does this kind of pixel art and graphics still exist? Do people still make textures and graphics that could run on a Chinese AirPods display? So I tried and it wasn't very good, like Netscape 6 kind of bad. And if I can't make it, surely AI can make it for me, because that's what we do in 2025, right? Can't draw? Ask AI. Can't code? Ask AI. And that's what I'm gonna do, goddammit. That's why I wasted 2 days of my time trying to extract CHR data from old ROMs and training a generative AI model to make them for me. In this 8-minute video, I'm gonna show you how I've done that, so stick around, it's gonna be fun. Okay, it is fun. First of all, I scoured the web, researching and learning about ROM headers, how the PRG ROM and CHR ROM is structured, which is where the sprites are contained. From there, I set up a virtual environment, got all the libraries ready, and got to coding. Because nothing says productive weekend like installing Python packages until 2 a.m. After that, I downloaded 2 fan-made ROMs to test out parsing a sample. Alright, Nintendo, they are fan-made, don't sue me. My lawyer is a YouTube comment section. And as you can see, the header is 16 bytes that spell NES, followed by MS-DOS end of file character. So with our iNES file ready and correct, I got into making the script, which reads the ROM file in binary mode, seeks past the 16 byte header, and extracts the CHR data section. The CHR ROM contains the character data, basically all the sprites, tiles, and graphics stored as 8x8 pixel tiles in a specific format. That doesn't seem right. Wait. There we go. CHR data is 8,192 bytes, which is correct. Math still works in 2025, who knew? And now we make the graphical extractor script where it takes each 8x8 tile from the CHR data, converts the 2-bit pixel data into actual image arrays, and saves them as PNG files. Each tile is 16 bytes, 2 bits per pixel, 64 pixels total. We're basically doing archaeological data recovery, but for pixels. And for the last step, we'll make a small script that saves the fetched dataset into a folder. Damn, they are beautiful! That's step one done! Now, for step two. I made, with a small little LLM help, a clustering script to get our dataset ready for training. The clustering script groups similar tiles together using k-means clustering based on pixel patterns and color histograms. This helps organize our dataset, separating characters from backgrounds, similar sprites together, and removing duplicates. And now, with our tiles clustered, I found a collection with 1,700 plus open domain ROMs. They're basically demos and visualizations, but full of tiles. It's like a pixel art goldmine, except legal and won't get me sued. To scale up and feed the PyTorch model more data to train on, let's modify the graphical extractor script to extract all .NES files in the ROMs folder and run it. Something is wrong. All tiles look the same now. Wait, do they actually look the same? That's correct. Good eye passed me. They're supposed to look similar. That's how NES graphics worked. Now for the clustering again. Oh, I failed to mention that the clustering script has a coloring part too, because the colors on iNES are indexed, not RGB. So you have to map the colors to a palette that corresponds to the game. Not all games have the same palette. It's like Instagram filters, but for the 80s. The NES uses a master palette of 64 possible colors, but each game can only use 4 colors per 8x8 tile. The palette data tells us which 4 colors from the master set each tile should use. Without this mapping, everything looks black and white, and after upscaling for a bit, this is what we have. And off to the training. I used a simple GAN architecture. Nothing too fancy. We're not trying to cure cancer here. Just make some pixels look good. And these are the results. Look at that, AI-generated NES-style tiles that actually look decent. Better than my hand-drawn attempts, that's for sure. I hope you guys enjoyed this journey into digital archaeology and neural networks. Please subscribe so I can pay rent and maybe afford better art skills. The notebook, scripts, and dataset are available on Kaggle and GitHub. Links are in the description along with my hopes and dreams. Tell me what you want to see in the next video. Bye.